Item number SCP-1981. Object class, safe. Special containment procedures. SCP-1981 is to be kept in SETA's secure video storage unit at the media archive of Site Blank. When in use, SCP-1981 should not be removed from its casing or exposed to any strong magnetic forces. A Betamax home video system and an analog television has been provided in Observation Theater 02 at Site Blank, as well as video equipment to record viewings. Description: SCP-1981 is a standard Betamax tape. Ronald Reagan cut up while talking has been written on the adhesive sticker and felt tip pen. Laboratory analysis indicates that SCP-1981 is made from an ordinary material and serial numbers correspond with a home cassette tape produced by in September of 1980. SCP-1981 was initially encountered by a filing clerk in the Ronald Reagan Presidential Library in 1991, who, upon watching it, alerted the police with the internet intent to find the tape's creator to press obscenity charges. A low-level police investigation was conducted, at which point the Foundation was alerted and secured SCP-1981. Class A amnesiacs were administered before Blank could be notified. Further investigation of the library's records by Foundation personnel failed to yield any leads on SCP-1981's origin. SCP-1981 appears to be a home video recording of former President of the United States Ronald Reagan delivering his Evil Empire speech to the Nation Association of Evangelicals at Sheraton Twin Towers Hotel, Orlando, Florida on March 8, 1983. However, 1 minute and 10 seconds of the speech begins to deviate heavily, eventually resembling no known speech ever made by Reagan. Beginning at approximately 5 minutes, multiple incisions, lacerations, and penetrating wounds can be seen being suddenly inflicted through no corresponding source of these wounds is visible. Despite suffering bodily harm that would incapacitate an ordinary person, Reagan will continue to deliver a speech until either his vocal cords are severed or the tape degrades at static at 2234. Upon rewinding SCP-1981 and initiating playback, Reagan will deliver an entirely new speech, often radically different from the ones previously observed. Topics include torture, child molestation, and ritual sacrifice. Trauma inflicted upon Reagan appears to be divergent, with commence genitalia genital mutilation and redacted, having all been observed in roughly 1-7 viewings of SCP-1981. The figure clothed in black robes and a conical hood will have been replaced by a random member of Reagan's press detail, henceforth referring to as SCP-1981-1. The significance of appearance of SCP-1981-1 is currently unknown. The speeches delivered by Reagan are mostly incoherent, lacking the sort of underlying thematic structure and highly being composed of nonsensical anecdotes and parables. However, occasionally references are made to future events that Reagan could not possibly have known about or predicted, such as the 9/11 terrorist attacks and the result of 2008 Russian elections in Blank. For this reason, rigorous time and effort has been devoted to recording the speech delivered on this linked playback. Attempts to replicate SCP-1981 into a similar Betamax tape have met with failure. However, cameras used to record the television SCP-1981 is broadcasted on have succeeded in capturing individual playbacks. Any observations performed on SCP-1981 must be recorded in the camcorder, provided with and delivered by for a subsequent review to Dr. Blunt B., project supervisor. It was a natural magnetic inference of severely degraded SCP-1981's signal quality, making it even more difficult to sift meaningful information from playbacks. Additionally, the gruesome nature of mutilations performed upon Reagan had been described as extremely disturbing, and for this reason has recommended that any personnel feeling squeamish or a lot to play back, you visit the psychiatric facility for a level 3 evaluation. As Ronald Reagan was alive at the time of SCP-1981's containment. A surveillance was deployed, and established for any relation between him and SCP-1981. No known connection was developed, though Reagan would frequently complain about nightmares before his mental state degenerated due to Alzheimer's.